Choose your character.
Level 1, go! September 7th, 2015, our systems finished updating and we logged into the first level of this new adventure slash choose your own story game known as Campion College. Our inventory was at its maximum capacity as we carried backpacks that were twice our size and bursting at the seams with textbooks. The only item in our character wardrobe were new uniforms so starched that they could probably walk on their own, and so large because we were told we'd grow into them eventually. Our mood bar was at its highest as we shook with nervousness and excitement. A new task immediately popped on our screens. Task 1, icebreakers. For the rest of the week, teachers will be conducting activities to introduce you to your new classmates. First impressions, vital. We needed to show who we were to these strangers using funny anecdotes and facts about ourselves before the time ran to zero. If you were lucky, you'd be able to sit by the palm trees and duck pond and befriend these strangers. In that moment, it seemed like a very high-stakes quest, that every part of our high school experience was riding on it. So much so that many of us tried harder than we needed to fit in with those we didn't belong with. Heck, for many, the progress on that quest was deleted in the very next level. The other aspects of our level 1 gameplay were just the pre-game tutorials, and we didn't even realize it back then. Many of us shed tears over the 80s and complained about low 90s, not realizing that this was as good as our grades were gonna get for a while. As we navigated our way through level 1, we were hit with many side quests to complete. Introduce yourself to your big sibling, that's the last time you're gonna see them for a while. Pay attention to Latin. Just because you heard you drop it after this year doesn't give you an excuse to the bare minimum, even if it's easy. Make Vine references. That app surely won't die. You're just being funny and quirky, okay? Walk. No, run to Mr. Suter's IT class. Mr. Suter does not tolerate lateness. Run to the canteen. The lines will become outrageously long and the upper schoolers don't play nice in there. Use the dog filter. That surely won't become outdated in a couple of years. Make sure your area reflects your character. After that, you may be seated. And our first boss battle, Campion Summer Term Exams, were completed. We advanced to level 2 with a new character badge added to our inventory. Mindfulness.
Level 2. New character trait unlocked. Waste manism. We made the cumbersome trek up the 3-story building, trading our turtle shells for limp pockets of fabric, containing only the bare minimum. First shift experienced the strange concept of having to go upstairs for the first time, while second shift felt as if they were the biggest and baddest because they were on the 3rd floor. Long gone were the days of fretting over homework and making sure projects were done weeks before the deadline. These were the days of early morning scribbling away, hot gluing, and hearing the call of, "Anybody have a fold of paper?" in breaks. We had arrived at our first major crossroad, TD or French. The choice to lug around T-squares, paper tubes, and boards half our size. Or to get completely roasted by Mr. Campbell because you've said, "Ban German, sir," and refused to join chapel choir. Listening to Despacito became the only reason we were willing to learn any more Spanish than hola, ¿cómo te llamas? A new foe approached each other. Daily rap battles never ceased to prove who was the so-called champion, number one on the leaderboard. New heights were achieved, and some of said heights were leapt off of in reckless abandon. Side quests emerged from left and right and center. Mr. Radcliffe's Shakespearean productions proved to be quite a curveball to our quickly sinking averages, forcing us to scramble together pieces of cardboard to make not-so-impressive balconies for Romeo and Juliet to rendezvous. Mini-games like bottle flipping were soon to be banned when one too many water bottles ended up on the archway to the library.
Start!
Hurry up!
I suck! You suck!
This was soon followed by the mannequin challenge, resulting in students in rather peculiar places. And no, guys, the tops of the lockers really weren't meant for sitting. Dangerous territories like Greenwall remained dangerous, and a place where fast walking was key, and tripping was to be avoided at all costs. Nevertheless, the year was soon over, and somehow, in between all the fooling around, there were some really impactful lessons learnt. And I mean, we're left with a new character badge. Ambition.
Level 3.
Our first real encounter with the concept of stress. The notion that third form would exactly mirror second form was quickly dispelled. The sciences were now split into biology, chemistry, and physics, which each posed their various challenges. Somehow, I still don't know how to measure with a micrometer screw gauge. Physics quests cited to go up in the numbers with various history, French, and geography group projects, consuming so much of our time, and quests outside of school to learn new skills, like how fast can one truly eat a burrito? Distractions appeared along the way, in the form of all classes becoming kindergarten math classes with chance of 2 plus 2 is 4, 1 is 1 at circuit maths. We channeled our nervous energy into new inventory items like fidget spinners, with competitions to see how long you could last.
Hi, welcome to my unboxing channel. Today we're going to be doing the Soup's On Trend fidget spinner. Oh my god, I'm so excited.
4, 3, 2, 1.
So easy, tell me, how is your life as a youngster?
Major tournament alert, multiplayer quest, do you accept? Of course our answer was yes. Any excuse to distract ourselves from school seemed like a perfectly reasonable one. And so, the C4 explosion competition and social was a go. With classes competing to have the best t-shirt designs. And of course, 3-1 winning. But I might just be a little biased. All of a sudden, we had all these choices to make, figuring out career paths and what subjects we want to do in CSEC. For the first time, careers rep was an event of interest, but in a way, both helped and completely overwhelmed us. Do I go down the science route
or do I explore business? What do I actually want to do with my life? It was a bit of a mid-school life crisis, if you will. But with the help of amazing teachers and guidance counselors, we are soon on our way to strategizing our future, finally unlocking our weapon of choice, a game plan.
Level 4. We were in the big leagues now, our first time in upper school. Suddenly, Dangerous Greenwall opened its arms to us and we were the cool kids on the block, or so we thought. Leaving behind the last year filled with some realm of normalcy, the friends we'd made and relatively no stress, September of the year 2018 made its appearance in our lives. Every single one of us had expectations for this year. Previous fourth formers warned us that we would be split up, not to do AdMath, and that the stress would not be normal. Did we listen? Did we properly prepare? That still remains to be seen. Our pre-CSEC year can be separated into four parts: adjustment, misplaced entitlement, stress, and an insatiable thirst for freedom. After the first week of routine icebreakers and warnings of "this year is filled with tons of work and no time for idling, you need to settle down," we finally realized that our friends from third form would not be with us this year, and teachers would not exactly tenderly hold our hands through these new subjects that we'd chosen. So then, new friends had to be made. Awkward conversations with persons we had no idea existed, and explaining that yes, we've been here since first form, would have to be done and dusted, because for the trials of fourth form, friendship would be desperately needed. AdMath outcries for help soon became a norm. New teaching styles took some getting used to. Group work was still a thing. The work piled up, and to our great dismay, surprise, and outright frustration, we had to deal with second and third formers on our breaks who made it nigh impossible to get lunch on time and to get to class on time. Some of our teachers took the tardiness in stride. Others, not so much. How blissful it was then to receive word of those tiny slips of freedom. The slips that would allow us to drop those subjects that we just couldn't handle or were asking more than we could give. The complaints lessened, and we all busied ourselves to prepare for Christmas exams, and afterwards, a jingle jam with our very own Leo Utaguchi and his dance group V10, who managed to give us something to cheer about at the end of the year. Rebecca Newman-Chung and Kajay Terrell also performed with an energy in stark contrast to our never-ending fatigue. January came, and with it, for most of us, our very first experience with cash pot grades. Oops, failed AdMath. Probably should have dropped that. A 60? Yes, I passed! Our classes were filled with these thoughts sailing through our minds, and as we struggled to regain the strength to keep pushing, to keep fighting, just a breath away from victory. Easter report victory, summer exam victory, and the biggest one, CSEC victory.
Do you ever look at someone and wonder what is going on inside their head?
Amidst these preparations, a dreaded and unexpected new rule arrested our cohort. In keeping with grooming regulations, all the boys here were to be 1 inch and not an inch more. Needless to say, the new rule posed an interesting challenge. Debates were had, hair was patted down, gel was forever in demand, scarring haircuts were made, and in time it seems that this rule would go unenforced, and the panic quieted down. Then came hair and other general grooming inspections. The game had just gotten real, and the only way to win was to comply. Eventually, even this uproar was pushed to the backs of our minds as work increased, seemingly impossible, but yes it did, and SBA stole our sleep, our patience, and just a tiny bit of our sanity. Fourth form drew to a close miraculously fast, almost as if it had been a brief, hectic, and traumatic dream. None of us would go unscathed from the rigor of our classes. None of us would come out of this year without having learned many important lessons. But all of us would have learned that the pressure was there. It was mounting, and it was time for us to step up to the plate, to be ready and to don our armor for the all-important regional exam. But of course, why waste summer? We'll have time to prepare next year. Nothing will set us back, or so we thought. We ended the year with loads of lessons under our belts, but the most important being a new character trait, illimitable.
Level 5, the final frontier. We lost a few of our friends along the way. No, they're of perfectly good health, don't worry. We were the head honchos now, although it didn't always feel like it. Bosses flew at us at the speed of light, with SBA's leadership roles creating new clubs, props to Campionites for youth activism, tons of homework, poetry recitals, and so much more. Burning the midnight oil and toiling away into hours of the morning became a new normal, with coffee mugs replacing the usual water bottles and carrying more bags than ever before, except this time under our eyes and not on our backs. Even with the added stress of CSEC approaching, we didn't let that deter us from our usual shenanigans. Activities of climbing chain link fences, climbing trees, playing cricket in a major walkway, and racing on a stretch of land that takes about 30 seconds to walk across. Yes, we are talking about Greenwall. Trips outside school were a price to be won and highly desired. It won us when we couldn't go to Father Holon for the first time. It was more than worth it to write ballads and sonnets to go on English trips with Miss Holdsworth Mackenzie. Bio students got to explore nature at Hope Gardens and had a blast breaking lab equipment. We swear it wasn't on purpose, we're sorry. While the geo students were out finding pretty rocks. Mr. and Miss Campionite was a battlefield we were ready to conquer. Our year group represented, with 7 fifth formers running. Conquer TikTok. Girl, go crazy when you treat her like your number one. Grad pick day. We showed up to school all glammed up. For the first time, we saw the boys get cleaned up. Grad pick day. We showed up to school all glammed up. For the first time, we saw the boys get cleaned up a bit, only to be sent home to remedy their incorrect shades of khaki or height of hair. The girls were fashionably late, and fashionable indeed, with their faces all made up and hair in intricate styles. Classes were missed, pictures were taken, and we frantically tried to avoid Mr. Anderson. As the year seemed to be coming to a close, the race to finish labs and SBAs was on. IT Part 1, Bio, IT Part 2, Physics Labs that seemed never-ending, and Math SBA, IT Part 3. Finish the group written report for English, cut down the word count on History SBA's IT Part 4, the website design, and worst of them all, IT Part 5, the programming section, a source of PTSD for most fifth form students. In the midst of all this, rest and recuperation were vital. Our health bars needed to be increased and were reclaimed whenever and wherever the opportunity presented itself. Upstairs in the library became a prime location for naps and relaxation. All that was left was the final stretch. 2 more months and exams would be over. It was a glitch in the game that no one could have anticipated. School closed, graduation cancelled, ball up in the air. Governments and hospitals were overwhelmed and countries were facing tragedies that haven't been seen in ages.
We became the Zoomers, online classes being the order of the day.
We lost a lot of quintessential senior year experiences.
We lost a lot of motivation.
We were sad and confused and anxious and frustrated and stressed out.
Constant back and forth and uncertainty about our future left us in limbo, not knowing where to go next.
It was hard. It is hard.
But we weren't going to let it stop us.
Our teachers often reminded us that a dream doesn't become a reality through magic. It becomes a miracle through hard work, determination, and perseverance. They inspired us to push through and keep our eyes on the prize. Friday afternoon Zoom calls became bonding sessions with games, discussions, and even a concert. Props to Mr. Hibbert and Ms. Shadadpuri. One glitch wouldn't mean game over for us, because we had learned to be steadfast. 5 years ago, as tiny first formers, we would never have known that our years at Campion would leave us with so many valuable life lessons, bonds we would cherish forever, and the people we would turn out to be today. Campion taught us to be special diamonds, manifesting the magic through every endeavor. Through mindfulness, ambition, game plans, being illimitable, and keeping steadfast, a true Campionite is molded. We've learned from every single experience, reminding us where we came from. We are champions pure and bold, climbing the tallest of mountains, diving the deepest of seas, surpassing all obstacles as we play this game of life. As the graduating class of 2020, we are now at the end of a treasured period, but at a precious beginning. Fortes in fide et opere.
Game over.